How are you all? Good morning. I'm Seema Sharma and I welcome you all in Infotainment Zone. I hope you have watched yesterday one video and I hope you all have learned a lot of things from that one. And today I have one more, a very informative video for all of you. Kids, you might be surprised that why I'm here in front of you with a lot of food items. Oh no, I'm not exactly eating anything in front of you. Instead, I'm going to teach you very important topic, that table manners. So kids, you might be thinking that why I'm here with such a boring topic for all of you. But this is not the reality. Table manners are really very important in everyone's life. Table manner, what is the meaning of table manner for all of you? Table manner is not simply eating food with everyone, or it's just simply eating food with your family members and relatives. Table manners and etiquettes are really a very important field to know and to learn. If you have good table manners, then you will be more confident while eating with your friends, relatives, and if you are going out where in restaurant with your family members, that time also table manners are playing a very important role. Before we start, let me introduce that what were things I have on my table. Here I have the main plate, the rice plate. In this I have rice, I have dry vegetable, as well as I have pickle. Then I have one fork and a spoon. Here one small plate, here one chapati. Then one bowl. But here I have pulses, dal, then pickle jar, napkin stand, salad, water, and the coaster. So kids, the first and the foremost rule we have here, that always wash your hands before going to the table, or we can say come to the table with clean hands and face. Why it is so important that we have to wash our hands and we have to clean our face? Let me tell you, because by washing your hands and by cleaning your face, you are showing your respect to the food and as well as you are showing your respect to the person who has prepared the food. And as well as this is also very important for your personal hygiene. And students, as you know, due to this pandemic, we shall wash hands again and again. So it's really very important to maintain our personal hygiene. So always come to the table with clean hands and face. Hamesha table पर आने से पहले, खाना शुरू करने से पहले अपने हाथ और अपना फेस अच्छे से धोएं और साफ करें. Okay? Now I'm going to tell you the second thing that you have to keep in your mind, that if you are just about to join the other people on dining table, or if you are just moving towards the dining table, then please move ahead and drag chair towards yourself without making any noise. Sit on the chair comfortably without interrupting any other person, and your back shall be straight. अपनी कमर को हमेशा डाइनिंग टेबल पे बैठते हुए सीधा रखें. So students, whether you are at home or you are going to someone else's house for dinner, always ask to grown up that in any ways if you can help to arrange the food on the टेबल। अपने बड़ों से चाहे आप घर पे हो या चाहे आप किसी के और घर इनवाइट किए गए हो, आप खाना खाने जा रहे हैं, तो हमेशा बड़ों से, अगर वो डाइनिंग टेबल पे खाने की आइटम्स को अरेंज कर रहे हैं, ऑलवेज आस्क देम कि आप उनकी मदद कर सकते हैं या नहीं। सो स्टूडेंट्स, इफ यू आर सीटेड ऑन योर चेयर एंड यू आर हंग्री एंड अबाउट टू ईट द फूड, देन डोंट मेक हेस्ट। प्लीज ऑलवेज वॉच योर होस्ट। इफ योर होस्ट इज अनफोल्डिंग द नैपकिन, then it is the signal for you to unfold the napkin and that time you can start eating. Now gently take one napkin in your hand and gently and nicely spread this napkin on your lap. So students, now I am going to tell you that exactly on the dining table everything is placed in which manner, and I am going to tell you everything as per the right-handed person, because I am a right-handed person, and suppose if you are a left-handed person, then everything is opposite for you. So students, here I have the food items for you all. See, let's get started. First of all, I'm going to tell you that everything is placed where on the table. The big plate or the main plate, this is you have to put the rice, the dry vegetable, and if you would like to take pickle, then on this plate you can take the pickle as well. Next comes the turn of chapati. The small one plate is for chapati. On this plate you can keep your chapati. The bowl are always for the vegetable with a gravy or the liquid vegetable. Then fork and knife and spoon, they are always to the reach of your working hand, your main hand, just like I have, my main hand is right one. The glass of water, it should be on your left hand side. So now always keep in mind that if you have arranged your food items or if somebody has already served the food to you, so don't jump over the food. Suppose if you are hungry and food is in front of you, so it's not like that you just at that time start eating. Wait until everyone is served the food. At that time you shall start eating. And students, in case you went to a restaurant, at that moment also always wait until everyone's food has arrived. Now I'm going to tell you that how to hold your fork and knife or spoon in your hand. Always take the fork in your left hand and the spoon, or if you would like to take knife, it should be in your right hand. So guys, now you have your fork and your spoon in your hand. So let me tell you how to start eating if the rice is provided to you. Do not fight with your rice and do not fight with your food. Gently and nicely take vegetable, mix with your rice, and with the help of your fork, arrange the food on your spoon and start eating gently and nicely. So students, if you are about to eat the chapati, then preferably use only one hand to take the bite from the chapati. Do not struggle with both the hands to take the bite. And side by side, always keep in your mind that never ever chew your food with mouth open. Always keep in mind that chewing your food with mouth closed and not talking while eating the food. These are two cardinal rules of the good table manners. Remember, never stuff your mouth at once. Always preferably take small bites. And never ever put a lot of food on your plate. If you are so hungry, if you are starving, that time also, that moment also, least quantity take at the first attempt. Afterward, if you are hungry, then take more. So it will help you to finish your food from the plate. So guys, if you have taken the less quantity of the rice or anything on the plate and that thing is, that food is finished, and now you want to take more from the main rice bowl, then do not reach to the food by yourself. Always request to the grown-ups to pass the food item to you, and gently, simply you can ask, could you pass the rice ball to me? Could you pass the vegetable to me? Suppose dal or any gravy, vegetable or the soup is served to you, then at that moment while eating, no slurping or blowing sound shall be created by you. You shall not create any kind of slurping sound. What is the slurping sound? When we are drinking water, when we are sipping the tea or any gravy vegetable, at that time no sip sound, no slurp sound shall be there. And remember, do not fill your spoon too much with the food. Always take less amount of the food. In case any gravy vegetable, curd or soup is served to you and very less quantity, very less amount is left on the bowl, at that time do not take the bowl, the katori in your hand and try to finish like that. Always try to finish the food with the help of your spoon. So students, अगर बहुत ही कम मात्रा में आपकी सब्जी या दाल या सूप रह गया है, तो आपने उसे अपने हाथ से उठा के उसको कटोरी को मुंह लगा के उस चीज़ को फिनिश नहीं करना है. आप उसे अपनी स्पून की, अपने चम्मच की सहायता से ही फिनिश करें. So see, if you have finished your meal, if you have done with the food, then always gently stand up and push your chair inwards to the dining table. At the end of the dinner, at the end of the meal, always say thank you. Always and always use these words to the host who has served the food to you, who has prepared the food for you, because it shows your manner, it shows your etiquettes, and in this way you can show your gratitude towards the people. And these all rules and these all table manners are playing always an important role in your life. I hope you all have enjoyed this video. I hope here you all have learned so many things, and next time you will apply all these rules and etiquettes while eating, while having the dinner with your family members. So students, you all have to prepare one good presentation with the help of your father and mother. You have to apply, you have to present the skills and the knowledge that you have learned throughout the videos that you have watched during the summer camp. You all can mention that thing there, and you all have to present a very good video there, and you will get one link to post your videos there. So students, take part in this and present yourself there nicely post a good one video there, and afterward the best one presentation will get the prize. So all the very best to all the participants. Thank you very much.